Today, I would like to introduce a new speech-to-video generation model from Alibaba. It's called Wan S2V, which stands for Speech-to-Video. This model is, of course, open source. Moreover, it breaks through the frame rate limitations of traditional models. Theoretically, it can generate videos of infinite length. Additionally, it supports various languages and features better dynamic effects. It also supports a diverse range of characters. With this model, you can effortlessly convert English into video. I believe I can fly. At the same time, its Chinese effect is also very good. Furthermore, it also supports Japanese. We will find that no matter which language, its lip-syncing effect is excellent. Beyond that, it can support various types of characters. For example, 3D characters.
Good evening, dear hearts. I come not to dazzle, but to drift, like a soft breeze trailing the scent of jasmine.
For instance, anime characters. Even animals are supported. Some prominent internet personalities have also conducted some very interesting tests with it. Among these, I believe the most valuable is what's called a stress test. Typically, stress tests are performed on websites or certain platforms to gauge access volume. These are traditional stress tests. So, what exactly does a stress test mean when applied to this model? Let's listen. This is an effect we observed during our stress test. I believe everyone now understands what this stress test signifies. Through this test, we ultimately confirmed that it possesses excellent speech-to-video generation capabilities. Currently, ComfyUI officially supports this model. You can find a list of related models in ComfyUI's official Hugging Face repository. Take a look. We can see this model, named Wan 2.2 S2V, within the diffusion models. Therefore, we can confirm that its underlying reference model should be 1.2. Besides this model, it also includes an audio encoder model. Essentially, this model converts sound into a vector, known as a wave vector. Please note, this model is only about 600 megabytes. Other models are generally compatible with the Wan model. However, please be aware that as of now, ComfyUI's official channels have not released an example workflow, or, to be precise, they haven't officially published this workflow. So, how can you find this test workflow? You can go to the ComfyUI page on GitHub. Within it, there's a commit titled vip1.2.2.s2v.model. Following that is a string of numbers, which is a pull request ID. You can click on it. After clicking, you will see an introduction to its basic usage. In addition to the model we just discussed, there is a test workflow. So, you can download this workflow and perform a test. Now, let's take a look at how this workflow appears after being imported. Overall, it's relatively simple. The structure of this workflow has not undergone any optimization, so I won't describe its structure for now. Let's first look at the results. Here, I have a reference image, and here's an audio segment. Let's listen. This song is very famous, called Stealing Time. Now, let's see. I have generated 77 frames. We can observe the generated effect. A journey with no return. You've heard the effect. Actually, there's a noticeable repetition in the tail end of the audio, almost like stuttering. Moreover, there's a clear flickering in the first few frames. Another issue is that the current sampling time is very long. My current frame length is 77 frames. Let's check the sampling time. It's now 9 minutes and 55 seconds. This duration is basically unacceptable, and the effect isn't particularly good either, right? This is our original workflow. This workflow merely serves as a guide. Some might ask why the sampling time is so long. You should note that the model size is very large. Let's take a look. This model is currently about 32 gigabytes. Therefore, It is significantly larger than our traditional 1 series models. The sampling speed will be relatively slower, so we must implement some acceleration measures. Now, let's look at our second workflow. For the second workflow, I made some basic structural optimizations. Here, let's first review the basic structure of this workflow. Take a look. This is our loaded main model. Please note, in its default workflow, the weight type here is set to default, which is BF16. I recommend choosing FP8 or FP8 Fast. I personally prefer FP8. Additionally, to accelerate it, I added a LoRA. This LoRA is quite simple. It's a light text 2V image to video acceleration model. This is our clip, and this is our V. The latter two parts are common with the Wan model. This concludes the model loading section. Next, let's look at the data processing section. Here, we have to input data points. One is the image we uploaded. Note that resizing is not required here. The second is our audio. Third, we've loaded an audio encoding model called Audio Encoder. This is the audio to vector model we just saw. Please note, although it says English, it supports multiple languages. There's a very important node here. Take a look. It's called Audio Encoder. Encode. It's a bit of a mouthful, right? We feed the audio into this spot and place our loaded model here. It will produce an output. This output will be used by another node called Wan Sound Image to Video. This has an input item called Audio Encoder Output. We simply connect it there. Then, we need to input the outputs of our positive prompt, negative prompt, V, and our reference image. Let's look at the prompt section. The prompt is not particularly important here, because you already have a reference image. So, I've written it very simply. A beautiful girl is singing. Here, we can set the resolution and frame rate. I've set it to 480*832, because this is a vertical format. Additionally, I've set a longer frame count, 121 frames. This is significantly longer than the previous 77 frames. Then, there's a basic sampling. Note that I've set the steps to 8. Since an acceleration LoRA was used, the CFG is 1.0. For the sampling algorithm, I chose UniPC, and for the scheduler, we selected Simple. Alright, now let's look at the generated effect. Take a look. The overall effect is much better than before, including the quality. So, this is a bit surprising. Using an acceleration, LoRA actually seems to produce better results than the original video. Furthermore, its speed has significantly improved. How long did this take? Let's run it and see. Okay, now we've finished sampling. You can see it took 4 minutes and 02 seconds. This time should be faster than the previous 9 minutes and 55 seconds. Some might say it's half the time, but you can't calculate it that way. Because I used 121 frames, and it used 77 frames. So, the acceleration should be about 3 times. Therefore, the acceleration effect is also very significant. Now let's look at the effect again. The initial shaking is still present in this effect. Let's listen again to see if the audio flaws at the end still exist. The good and the bad are all scenery. The flaws at the end still exist. So, it still needs further processing. This is a workflow we recommend for using this model. This way, the speed will be faster. In this workflow, I also tested a horizontal version. The overall result did not change much. The reference image became a horizontal one. I set the resolution to 832 by 480. It's still 121 frames. Let's listen to the effect. The problem still exists. However, I think the overall performance is still good. This workflow was mainly used to test how the effect performs when we zoom out the camera to a wider shot. Overall, there are no issues. The consistency of the character is also well maintained. Overall, we can only say that this model is satisfactory, because compared to multi-talk or infinite talk, it does not have significantly outstanding advantages. In terms of character performance, sound performance, lip syncing, and video quality, I think they are all at the same level. Furthermore, I conducted some additional tests. I attempted to incorporate Wan context here. As we all know, the new version of ComfyUI has such nodes. This would allow it, similar to KJ's model, to support longer frames. This is achieved through a sliding context window. However, in my tests, connecting it resulted in an error. So, this is currently unusable. At present, KJ's Wan video extension is also advancing the development for the Wan's 2V model. I believe that in KJ's extension, the context node should be usable. In that case, we would be able to generate infinitely long videos. At that time, we will conduct more detailed tests for everyone. That's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.